Hey everyone, good afternoon, and we got a new box, and it's from Lou Gaming, and this theme is based upon the booty, which means as in treasure, not as for ass, so, exactly, and as always, my sister Aisha is here to help me out, and try out all this cool stuff while we're watching Aliens. So
in the background, just as a background.
Yeah, as a background.
Don't have any cool music, and this
is then again, this is a really awesome movie. Have you ever think about Aisha of cosplaying as Ripley? I think you would have been excellent.
I would, but I mean, I've never seen the movie, so I'm a horrible person. Yeah. All right, let's get to opening.
All right, well, all the more reason to go catch up in your dojo, catching up with the aliens.
In a little bit, not right now.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, now, the certain series or franchises based upon this booty theme is, obviously, you know, one of them is Uncharted.
Of course.
The other one is Assassin's Creed Black Flag. The other one is Crash Bandicoot.
Ew.
And the other one is Sea of Thieves.
But I mean, would you really consider Crash Bandicoot like something that would be under that category? Because you're not really hunting for treasure.
I think.
But you break crates.
Yeah, I think in a
but
way.
You do find gems.
You do find gems. You also, in this current trilogy, the Insane trilogy, you actually obtain relics as well. So you do obtain those. You obtain gems of different colors.
Yeah.
So, I mean, technically speaking. However, I am a bit surprised that the following series are not there. Like one of the games based upon Indiana Jones, like The Emperor's Tomb, which was an Xbox exclusive at that time during the early 2000s.
I guess it would just depend on like how popular the series is for the franchise was. Like, we all know Crash Bandicoot, everybody knows the Uncharted series. Everybody, you know, majority of people consider Black their favorite. I actually know somebody, a friend of mine, who actually likes the third one of Assassin's Creed. Me, personally, I like them all, but my favorite assassin is Altair.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. I mean, those are more well-known and popular series, so I think they just kind of want to keep things more to what we know, instead of having a lot of kind of underground stuff.
Yeah, well, actually, one of them, what it could have been, was also Tomb Raider, since it's been there for over 20 years, and
yeah.
With the recent one that came out for the PS4 was The Rise of the Tomb Raider.
Mm-hmm.
That could have been actually an excellent contender. That one. Let me see. There was another one that came into my mind. I don't know. What do you think? Borderlands could have been an excellent category?
I don't know. I would consider more Borderlands a shooter. I mean, once again, I played some of the game. I have not passed it, so I don't really know if, say, thieving would be part of the experience of Borderlands. I'm sure there's the YouTube community, you can correct this and tell us yes or no. But to my knowledge, from what I've played with Borderlands, I wouldn't consider it that way.
You know, also Ratchet and Clank could have been also, because you do find or discover weapons. Some, especially, I think Sammy went to, I think it was Ratchet and Clank Future.
Yeah.
In which you had to pick up schematics for Rhino, which is the most powerful weapon in the game. So, yeah, that could have been another contender.
Yeah, I guess, like I said, there's a lot of them, but I think they also have to kind of figure out what would be more attractive to people. But we could literally make a podcast about genres and stuff, but we're not gonna do that right now.
We've
got like 5 minutes.
Well, that's okay. I mean, we could always put that in mind. You know, we'll have our own little we could always share our thoughts through our channels. Aisha, do you want to mention about your YouTube channel or
My YouTube channel is not very awesome. awesome right now. It's pretty lame. I don't even know what it would be under, so I will not give that away. But if you want to find me on Snapchat, Kalsuki, that's what it is, C-A-L-S-U-K-I. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm spelling it right. So for anybody who wants to follow me, I am going to go ahead. You're going to see me singing a lot, so...
There you go. So anyone who's into singing, here's your thing. Don't forget, guys, that there are some cons that actually have karaoke panels. There's also, you'll be surprised, there's actually quite a few places where you could actually, you know, sing along. So if you have a singing voice or you just want to...
We don't have a singing voice because we're not, this is an American Idol.
Yeah, you know, just go ahead and just sing your heart out.
Okay, so let's go ahead and get to unboxing this box. Okay. So, t-shirts first, like always?
Yes, absolutely. T-shirts, I am thinking... Okay, thanks for just pulling it out like that.
Because I was just going to, like, surprise both of us, but, I mean, go ahead and make your guess.
Yeah,
you make your guess.
Now, if you were a guy, I think that would have been a smooth move. Like, say, like, hold on, let me pull it out.
Nah, like, I would have had more grace than just kind of, like, put my arms over it and be like, I'm embarrassed. So, go ahead.
Okay. I'm assuming that this has to be based upon, let me see. I would have to say Sea of Thieves.
Sea of Thieves? Okay. I'm going to go with Crash Bandicoot.
Okay.
Look at me. I'm so smart. Oh, this is actually a nice shirt.
Well, let's take a look at this nice shirt.
Greetings from Insanity.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, I actually kind of like this. It's not black. Thank you.
And yeah, sometimes it does get a little bit stale when it's always, you know, it's a black color shirt.
Yeah, so.
Look at that. Yeah, anyone who's a big fan of the series?
Aside from us, I'm pretty sure there is a few people who, you know, hit memory lane with it, but that's about it.
Yeah, as you can see from the, now for the people who have been following me on my, channel, I've been playing a little bit of Crash Bandicoot, the, trilogy. So far, I am still currently at the slippery climb stage. It is very, it's a bit of a problematic.
Hit memory lane with me. What was that one? I don't remember.
This is the one where you're entering to the castle.
Oh, God.
That's already hidden there?
And the frustrations are coming back in, like, full waves, like, full, like, ocean hurricane. We're like, it's wrecking me right now. I don't like it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that.
I
love the castle, but I hated that stage.
Yeah.
That one is Stairway to Heaven.
Stairway to Heaven.
It was not... Stairway to Heaven, which is probably more of a song than I'm thinking.
Absolutely, obviously. Road to Nowhere?
Road to Nowhere.
Yes.
The original one, jeez Louise. And then we ended up finding out that we could actually just, like, walk on a rope.
Mm-hmm.
And just make it easier for us. But, God, jumping on there was so hard.
It was. Do you remember that one time that we discovered the super password? And we just went straight to... Yeah, we just said F you to the Road to Nowhere, the bridge episodes, the bridge levels, slippery climb, and we just went to just a rest.
Yeah.
So.
That was a good childhood memory.
It was. I don't worry, guys. I'm going to catch up with the game. It's just, there are some games that does take rather some patience. I've been watching a couple of YouTube channels. YouTube episodes on how to pass slippery climb with a bit of an ease. So,
just put butter on it.
Yeah.
It's easy.
Yeah. Right now I'm going to try to finish up with Resident Evil 4. Like I said, please be patient and I will try.
Demand for your videos, YouTube community. That's why we're here.
Right. Okay. So we got the Crash Bandicoot out of the way. So we got Uncharted, Black Flag, and Sea of Thieves.
Oh, Sea of Thieves, whatever.
Yeah, alright.
Okay, so we got two boxes. One is more of a rectangular kind. It almost feels like it would be kind of like a coaster type of thing. And then you got another one that's probably going to be like a Q fig or pop figurine. and then you got something else that's like kind of in a bag. I think it's, I don't know what it would be. I mean, it feels like it's cloth, but I don't know.
You think it might be like a flag related to the coon of Coon and Friends from our last box?
I wouldn't doubt it.
I mean, if that's the case, then I'm assuming it would have to be Black Flag.
Okay, so which one do you want to go? Do you want to go with the coaster-looking box, the Q-Fig, possibly pop box, or the thing that might be a flag box?
The thing that might be a flag.
Okay. I think it's a towel.
Holy crap.
Keep this bag away from babies and children. Sorry, bro.
Alright, sorry, kids.
No, sorry, you. You're still a child. You bitch. See you, thieves.
Oh, look at that.
Oh my god, this is actually a really, really neat idea. Oh, you can kind of see it.
Well, I can see the outlines.
This is a really nice idea. I actually like it.
Wow. It's like a flag. It's but a towel.
Well, not necessarily.
Like a flag towel.
Well, I mean, no, dummy. Pay attention. Like, the eye patch and the eyes are boats. You got the rock for the nose. People down here for the mouth. Mm-hmm. And you got the cloud. So it's kind of like a hidden image that makes into a skull. That's what I'm talking about. Gee, why are you going to interrupt me?
Well, I'm just giving you my thoughts.
Your thoughts are irrelevant right now.
Well, this is my channel after all, so...
Screw your channel. I'm just going to do my own YouTube videos.
Well, I sure better start hollering ass.
Well, I'm
going to
do it once, like, I start getting my own.
Who knows? I mean, if you have... if you become a Loot Crate Survivor.
Survivor
Loot Crate
Box.
Once you become a subscriber, you know, I'll be your assistant and, you know, I'll give you, you know, thoughts. And stuff like that, so...
Because if you don't want it, I'm taking it.
Yeah, go take it.
The fifth towel I've gotten.
Yeah.
Actually, no, this is actually the second towel I've gotten from Loot Crate. The first one was actually Dead Island.
Exactly.
I magically found, without even meaning to, it was literally that son of a biscuit. I have my sewing kit, my box... with my fabric patterns and then the fabrics that I was going to make a skirt with, and that son of a bitch was just laying there like a French girl waiting to get painted. I was like,
yeah. It happens to us all, but the good thing is now you found your Dead Island towel.
I found my Dead Island towel, which I'm very happy, and now I have a new towel to go and take it to Planet Fitness.
Yeah. Now, my question is this, Isha, since now within less than a week you'll be heading to Romania, are you going to be taking both towels as your,
Not really, because, I mean, if anything, I would probably... I wouldn't even know which one to take, because it's like... They're not... Neither of them are appropriate. But, if I really had to choose, I would take my Dead Island one.
There you go. Okay.
So, that's not bad.
Alright, and so two out of the four have been knocked out. Now we need is the Uncharted and the Black Flag.
Okay, I'm thinking the Black Flag is going to be the coaster and the Uncharted is going to be like the cute big thing.
I think it's going to be the opposite.
You think it's going to be the opposite? Okay.
You what? What? I'm sorry, what was that? Yeah. I'm sorry, I saw that reaction right there, kind of like the little gasp. What was that?
Uncharted
4. Now, is it really what you think it is? Is it like a coaster set, or?
I mean, because I don't really know anything else that would be, like, I don't know. I want to assume it's a coaster. If it is a coaster, I'm going to have to start reading my book so I can actually put this on my table and then
right.
Have my drink there.
Well, open it, Isha.
It's like a little, oh my god.
What?
It's like a little pouch. Oh my god, I'm fine, I can't even English right meow. Oh my lord, Jesus Christ, this is oh my god. I'm a man of fortune and I must seek my fortune. Oh my god, check that.
Alright, there you go, let's take a look at this.
Okay.
Oh, it looks pretty cool.
Oh, it's awesome. It's like a wallet.
Yeah, you could say it's a wallet, but then again, I mean, I wouldn't really put my money in here.
I would.
Well, I mean, if you're going to go to, like, say, a pocket within a pocket, you know what I mean? Like, a wallet within a pocket and within a pocket, but...
See, you don't know how to think like a thief, man. This is why you can't live that thief life.
No, it's just that for me, I'd rather make sure that my wallet is well secured before, you know, it just simply just... You know, slides out. Like, oh, where's my wallet? Oh, it's now with the floor, which is now with some guy. So, yeah it is a really cool wallet.
I know. Did you take my coin?
Did I? Was there a coin in there?
Dude, you literally just took my coin.
Did I really? I mean, seriously.
I swear, like, there was a coin.
Are you
I swear, I
just opened up the pockets and that's all I did. I don't think there was nothing in there.
I swear there was literally
a Bitcoin or
yeah, like it's you were able to see it sticking out, like that's what I'm saying.
Are you sure? Because I mean
swear. You tossed I'm literally willing to get money right now.
Well, I mean, we could always, you know, find it after the clip, because right now we got less than 4 minutes.
Literally stole
it. Well, I wouldn't say I stole it.
Like
it's more like...
Thief.
Well, I don't know about that. I mean...
Yes,
I retired from thieving a long time ago.
Yeah, you know,
I could tell you...
You know what I call that? I call that BS.
No. I mean, I'll tell you what was the last thing I stole. Or I got caught stealing. No, it was actually a dirty magazine.
You're sorry.
So what about the last box? Black flag.
Is in fact black flag. Oh, this is kind of cute. So it's like the Halo one that we got last month, I believe. It's the liquid screenshots. So yeah, it's black flag. And you got Edward
Kenway,
yep.
Right there.
It says on the back, take the seats with this charismatic captain. At the heart of Assassin's Creed Black Flag, Edward Kenway, as he finds himself caught up in the ancient war between assassins and Templars, while on his quest for gold and glory.
There he is, a little bastard with his little Captain Morgan pose.
Right? Okay, let me take him out so we can get like a better look at him.
Okay, while you do that, I'm going to try to look for your damn... Oh, is it like within a little pocket, like a little plastic bag, or...
No, it was
a fallout.
Let's
go. Let's see. Okay, now, right now, guys, we're doing a little bit of a
thieving situation.
I wouldn't say thieving. I mean, what benefit will I get from taking
you
a...
Did you cry?
Oh, are you sure? That's a long time ago. Okay. Well, the funny thing is that we have Bill Paxton here in the movie.
That ain't gonna help me find my damn coin.
Well, the thing is that wait a minute.
Did you find it?
No, I thought I saw something shining. But then again, I might be misleading. No, because I remember you grabbed it. You tossed it here, so it must be. Around here and around the chair.
But it's not, because I remembered I closed it.
Yeah, maybe it slid into the... You see, well, you got the... Oh.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That's pretty cool. Okay, just keep looking. Maybe it's on the side. No, there is nothing. Oh, it looks really cool. Okay. No, it's not. Wait. Hold on. You heard a thump?
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Bo Paxton. Bo Paxton's character. Oh, goodness. This guy has such a mouth. You know, it's funny because in Titanic, he was pursuing or looking for a special item, the heart of the ocean, the heart of the sea.
I think the heart of the sea.
Yeah, so it's okay. I mean, it's not lost. It's just simply misplaced.
For all eternity.
Okay. Well, I wouldn't say for all eternity, but it's going to pop out. Oh, goodness, Isha. Well, yeah, I understand that, but...
Found it!
What? So, see? Holy.
I told you.
See, so this is the coin that she was looking for it.
Boy, you can't stop a thief.
Oh, God.
Oh! See? See, this is why we can't have nice things in this house.
Wow, look at that. Okay, well, I'm glad. Are you going to make this into, like, a necklace? Like drill a hole and put on the.
Why would I do that? I'm just gonna leave it.
Well, I'm gonna put it right here, okay? Look at. I even have this videotaped, so.
No.
That way, see? Nice. You guys see that? Nice. I left it right there in that box.
He didn't leave it in that box. He's lying, see?
So look at that. You know, it would be nice if it had other wallet right next to him. That would be badass. Okay.
So
that's good to know.
Oh, you can take it off. Okay.
All right, now for later on, I'm going to take it out of the box and put it right here, somewhere in this crap. There is space.
Just leave them out in that space?
Just leave, like, halfway open, please. Like, put the... just leave it outside. Well, I'll find a place for it. Okay. So, Isha, do you think you have enough time to assemble this box?
Oh, yeah. It's not a ghost. So, I mean, for anybody who knows what happened, in the previous Loot Gaming or Loot Crate session, they actually made the box the ghost from Destiny, and I decided to be an adventurous person and try to assemble it. Well, off camera, I was still working on it. But for whatever reason, I couldn't get it right, so Ghost was unfortunately left to be recycled, so...
Yeah, so, for
shame. But the other ones, I've been able to do just fine.
Yeah, the other ones, right now we still have the, I think it's the Future Tech one, the robot, and we have the T-Rex that's currently upside down because he wants to do some Pilates or yoga, and from the Primal... box. As you can see, Isha is almost done on TTF, Two Tucks on a Fold. On the
Multiplicity, they were smart. That was a very smart catchphrase.
Yeah. Right? And that's okay, Isha, it's just a box. I don't think there's any more treasures left in there.
No, but there is a cat eyes.
There you go. In case you ever try to touch more crap. Alright, so that basically wraps up for today's or for this month's last month's
this session's Loot Gaming.
Yeah.